Hey guys, it's Dave from Gamers on Games, and today we're going to be talking about Dust. So, a discussion broke out on the Dust forums about how the Pounder, the sort of standard medium walker for the Allies, is not going to cut it as an anti-vehicle platform despite its anti-tank gun. So, I started thinking about what are some of the best anti-vehicle options available to the Allies. So, we're going to go through all the Ally vehicles available at this point with anti-vehicle capability. Now, we're defining anti-vehicle capability as weaponry that can damage all grades of vehicles, even all the way down to a 1-1 stat. If the vehicle is capable of damaging all grades, then it will be part of this series. A last note before we get started. I fully believe that at this point, the Allied forces are underpowered, as many of their vehicles are just lacking in abilities or capabilities that keep them alive, and generally the costs are too high for that lack of durability.
Gamers on Games is sponsored in part by.
I'm Lynn from Metalhead Minis. Great to meet you. Be sure to check us out online at metalheadminis.com. You can find out more about our services, such as miniature painting. We also do consignment. We also teach at local game stores. Be sure to check us out at metalheadminis.com. Thanks for having me.
Hi, this is Dennis with 3D Game Gear. We are gamers with a family-run business that specializes in 3D printed accessories for board games. We offer a wide range of items, including tokens, token cups, token boxes, player dashboards, and much more. We are always adding new items to enhance your gaming experience, so come check us out at the address below.
And by viewers like you.
We're going to start with the Pounder, as it is the origin of this conversation. The Pounder is a Class 4 medium walker with 6 health and a top speed of 5. It is armed with a single anti-tank gun, one machine gun, and one heavy machine gun. Let's focus on the anti-tank gun. It gives you one die per infantryman and does one damage per hit, against all ranks. When it comes to vehicles, it only gives you a single die, but auto-kills Class 1 and 2 vehicles. At Class 3, it does 5 damage for that one shot. Classes 4 and 5, you are getting 4 points for each hit. At ranks 6 and 7, you're only doing 3 points. So what does this mean? It means that at baseline stats, you have 1/3 of a chance of hitting the target, much less doing damage, keeping in mind the possibility for cover or damage resilient. Considering the weapon auto-kills rank 1 and 2 vehicles, something you'll see very common with other vehicles in this series, some of which can auto-kill higher rank vehicles for about half the cost, it isn't that impressive. About the only things this weapon has going for is its range and turret arcs. 16 range will reach out and touch most of the map, excluding terrain interference, and most maps do not allow for these sort of firing lanes. The turret will give you the freedom to fire the anti-tank gun in one direction, but allow your machine guns to still pelt infantry in different arcs. So at 13 points, is the Pounder really worth it as an anti-tank platform? In a word, no, not really. Unless, and it's a big unless, you are going to go fully in on making an Allied medium combat walker platoon. I say this because the platoon bonus reads as follows. All M3 medium combat walkers in or supporting the platoon can use the Get Moving You Bunch of Monkeys special action on any M3 medium combat walker in the same platoon. This means that you have the potential of giving almost all of your tanks the chance to reactivate to take a second shot. The best way I can really explain this is to have you think of it like a group of Shermans swarming a Tiger tank. Considering the very appearance of the Pounder is a Sherman with legs, it seems a fitting analogy. So what if the Pounder isn't an anti-vehicle unit? What is the Pounder really best suited for? Frankly, it's an amazing anti-infantry platform, and it isn't too shabby at hurting aircraft either. Assuming you are attacking a Class 1 or Class 2 infantry squad, and you are really committed to making sure it's removed from the board, you're throwing a maximum of 17 dice and a minimum of 16 dice at it. If even a third of them hit, that gives you 5-6 hits. Assuming they make a third of their saves, We're assuming that they're in the open or otherwise lack cover. That brings it down to one or two saves. So either you wiped out the squad, or they have one or two guys still in play. Not terrible, not great, but definitely something that can be cleaned up by your infantry or by a heavy machine gun from another pounder. Now, I assume some of you are wondering why I'm not counting sustained fire into that calculation. And the reason is that you're doubling down on pounders or M3 walkers in general you've built into the Allied Medium Combat Walker Platoon, and you're reserving that action to trigger Get Moving, You Bunch of Monkeys on the next tank so that you can chain this down the line, hopefully, and get yourself a firing line of pounders flinging lead every which way. Just an absolutely outrageous amount of firepower being thrown downrange. So I hope this gives you some ideas about the tactical capabilities of the pounder. We'll be using the pounder as our zero mark for all future episodes and comparisons, because, as stated in the beginning, it was the origin of this series. Let us know what you think about this tactical analysis, and we'll see you in the next episode when we explore the Bushmaster. Pros. Medium walker so hard to one-shot kill. Can be built out into a medium walker platoon to allow for extra chances of making the shots connect. Long range on the anti-tank gun. Turret. Cons. Pricey. No special abilities. Requires several of the M3 walkers to be effective. Only a 33% chance of hitting. More effective as an anti-infantry platform than anti-vehicle. Just a reminder that everything you see here on Gamers on Games is made possible by patrons like you. Why not check out our Patreon page? It would really help us out.